like to discuss today the events on solar materials and application for gastroesophageal reflux disease. When you build design a transoral stapling device, there are a few challenges raised during the design. First of all, it should be flexible. Then it should be a small enough diameter to be safely introduced into the patient. Need to take care about no cross-contamination with patients. Endoscopic vision is required, and stapling tissue requires that tissue thickness is measured in a certain point to make sure that the tissue is fully closed. The solution for all these challenges is the MUSE, the Medigus ultrasonic surgical endostapler. This is a flexible working length with a 50.5 millimeter diameter. This device resembles gastroscope, but it includes also disposable staple. The system also includes a console, monitor, and all the common accessories for producing the device. The system is already CE marked and FDA cleared. Yeah. Similar to any gastroscope, the device includes suction and irrigation. But I would like first to focus on the vision capabilities of the device. The device itself includes a built-in camera, so no additional endoscope is required. The illumination is provided by LED. And these advances are critical of making the device disposable, and thus patient cross-contamination is eliminated by risk. I would like to now draw your attention to the ultrasound transducer on the distal tip of the device. It ensures the alignment of the stapler and as well measuring the thickness of the tissue. During the articulation of the device, the distal tip of the device touches the tissue. There is where the direct visualization is lost, and there is where the ultrasound comes in. As I mentioned before, on the distal tip of the device, here and here, we have the ultrasonic transducer. On the opposite side, here on the shaft, and there is the cartridge, and the cartridge includes an ultrasonic mirror. Now, what happened here is that from the distal tip, ultrasonic signals are propagating to the cartridge and reflect back by the mirror. The alignment of the stapler is achieved by the signal strength of the ultrasonic signal. If both parts of the staples are aligned, by means of the distal tip is aligned to the cartridge, then strong signal will be received. If there is misalignment, then the signal will be lost and there will be no signal, so there is no misalignment. The tissue thickness is measured by the console, taking into account the round-trip time of the ultrasonic signal. It is important to measure the tissue thickness in order to get optimal staple V-shaped form, and I thank Dr. Swanson for giving some background about it. You can see here an optimal V-shape, and if the tissue is too thick, then the formation will not so sufficient, and if it is thin, then staple will pinch the tissue. All of this is displayed on a graphic user interface. What you see here is the monitor. The monitor displays and gives control and instruction throughout all the procedures to instruct the operator. Here you see the direct visualization, and when the distal tip touches the tissue, then the display switches automatically to animation. What you see here is the representation of the cross-section of the device. Here, this is the distal tip of the device. And this round is the working shaft where the cartridge is. And the bending shape here represents the tissue that is between the anvil and the cartridge. And as I said, we need to be in optimal position to get the V shape. So we achieve our goal. We are stapling simultaneously five staples, and after stapling, the device will go back, reload, and insert again. And the procedure repeats two or more times per patient. The staples that we are using is 4.8 titanium staples. These are standard staples that are used in drink staples, auto sutures. These staples are used for 6 decades in gastroesophageal anastomosis, and it has proven their durability. The next step, the system is now will be launched in selective centers. We are still collecting more medical data to be published, and I can say proudly that recently we were announced that our manuscript was received to be published in the surgical endoscopy. And if you find this this device interesting, you are welcome to visit our booth.